This is Strange Love, and I'm your host, Cami Chaos. Welcome, babies. Actually, that would be good morning, but I really am Cami Chaos, and this is day two of the OS Bridge Conference, and we're here right now with Emma Jane Hogben. Hello, Emma. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for joining us. It's not really bright and early anymore, but thanks for joining us early. Where can we find you on the internet and on Twitter?
EmmaJane.net, both as a URL and as a handle on Twitter. Twitter and Identica, we'll just merge those into one word.
Oh, with the DOT?
Yeah.
EmmaJane.net?
Yeah.
Okay, so you are here speaking today?
I am speaking this afternoon, yes.
And you're speaking with Selena?
With Selena Deckelman. We are doing the Bizarre versus Git Smackdown. It should be really exciting.
And which side are you, Bizarre or Git?
I'm Bizarre.
What's going to go on? What time is the talk?
Later today. There's a schedule there. We'll just take a look. I think we're the last session of the day.
Okay.
So that's really the best way to end a conference is with two women in nice clothes fighting about version control systems.
I know you're on here. I see a drinking game.
Yeah, no, we're not the drinking game.
No?
Sorry.
People were very excited. We could make a drinking game
out of
Bizarre versus... Oh, right here. Yeah. At 5 o'clock in Hawthorne.
There we go. Great. I know where I need to be now.
Yes, at 5 o'clock in Hawthorne. Until then, you can just kind of...
Meander.
Meander about and see what's going on. When did you come on to talk at the conference?
Wow, this is like the 10 o'clock a.m. question. Me going, what do you mean by that? More words, please.
I seem so sleepy until I actually start to talk and ask questions. I'm like, look, no, I'm up. When did you just... yeah, my phrasing. Let's see. When did you become involved?
What was the idea? What were you thinking?
Yes. How long ago, and what was the idea that led you to want to talk here?
Selena has been giving a Git is awesome talk, and I've been giving a version control for mere mortals talk, and... I don't remember who started it, but one of us decided that we needed to have some kind of smackdown because they're essentially the same talk, but from either point of view.
Mm-hmm.
And her conference was the next one with an open call for papers. And so I put in the proposal, which made it pretty much official. Mm-hmm. And here we are.
Very, very cool. When did you get involved in open source?
Oh, wow. I've been using open source on the server for more than 10 years, exclusively on the desktop platform for 8 years, I think. So a while.
And what led you to want to use open source software?
I'm cheap.
You're cheap.
It was I'd just done an informational interview with a guy who had a row of Adobe boxes in his office, and I believe my exact words were, "Dude, don't you know you can get that for free from Ware's sites?" And this is the owner of a company, and I'm there doing my informational interview.
Mm-hmm.
And his response was, "Well, a carpenter doesn't steal their tools, so why should I steal mine?"
No, it's not stealing.
And that was really an eye-opening moment for me because I had been using illegal software because that was what I could afford.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I started looking for the open source equivalents, things that I could afford. Started out using freeware tools and then switched over to open source. And for me, what's kept me involved in open source is the community aspect to it. So
there is a really... large, and in Portland we see a huge tech community in general, but there is just this kind of do-it-yourself, become involved, give back to everybody community, not just with, you know, what's going on online and on the computer, but where do you see that most reflected?
I've got a fairly interesting situation in that I live in a fairly small town up in Canada. We're just over 20,000 people, surrounded by rural, mixed use farms.
Mm-hmm.
And open source is a really interesting way for us to bring the physical community together. So I extend it beyond the code base and actually look at open business as well. So I've got a free Drupal help night where there's about a dozen of us who get together and everyone brings their questions. They're all clients of mine.
Mm-hmm.
And they bring their questions and they sit around and it basically means that I get to answer questions, but they also get to support one another. And these are people who previously had been really pretty afraid of technology. But because they're using the same tool, because it's open source, they understand that that part is important to me, and they extend that to their business communities as well. And they tend to get a little bit competitive. So if one of them has a mailing list, then everyone wants a mailing list if one of them. So it's interesting to see how being open about more than just code changes, can change a physical community as well.
Do you want to tell us about your book, Frontend Drupal?
Yeah, so I ended up co-authoring a book on Drupal with Konstantin Kafer, and this is our first book, and it's been really exciting, kind of scary, but really exciting. It's on how to make Drupal, which is a content management system, look the way you want it to look instead of the way the code base wants it to look. And we've had really great response from it. It's been out for 2 months. We're already going to second printing, which is very nice. We've signed the contract to do instructional videos to go along with it as well. They'll be out starting in August. The first set will be released. And it's been really a lot of fun to see how the community or the readers sort of receive the book. And there was a couple of things like, you know, it's 2 o'clock in the morning and you have to submit your chapter and you have to write an introduction. You're like, oh, this is, I don't want to do this. I'm just, oh, this is going to be the pirate chapter. And the editors didn't actually take it out. So we have chapter 5 starts with, this is the pirate chapter, exclamation mark. Which is what you want from your technical books.
So if you want to stay awake sometimes when you're reading your technical books, that is what you want out of them.
So we had some fun with it, and it has been well received because we had that fun with it. And people they're not used to seeing humor in technical writing. So
there's one more thing I want to talk to you about before you go, because very obviously you're here at the open source conference. We're talking about open source, and very obviously you're a woman.
It's true, I am.
And in Portland, we see that more and more.
Yeah.
But tell me a little bit about that. How is that for you? And
it's really interesting for me, especially because I constantly feel like I'm surrounded by women, and women tend to cluster, especially at large conferences where you sort of walk into a room and you try to find someone that you think you may have something in common with. So you get these sort of groups of women, and then you look at the statistics, and statistically, depending on which community you're looking at, you know, Drupal is lucky that it has 11% women showing up at conferences. And then you look at Open Source Bridge, and 1/3 of the speakers are women. So we see some communities that are doing really, really well. And I'm always excited to be part of the communities that are trying to make a difference. I was talking to Gabrielle yesterday about her talk, and we've decided that there needs to be that every woman in open source eventually ends up giving the women in open source talk. We've decided to call this the unicorn law. It's kind of like Godwin's law, but a little bit different. And Sarah Sharp confirmed that indeed she has given the talk, and Selena has given the talk, and so we've decided that it's inevitable.
Did anyone give the talk at this conference?
Gab did, yeah.
Gab, okay. Yeah. You just said that. Hello, wake up, Cam.
It's okay, 10 a.m. Yeah, yeah.
I was with you all right until I asked that question. The second it came out of my mouth, I was like, you just said that. All right, Emma, on that lovely high note,
yes.
Thank you so much for joining us.
It was Thanks
great
for
to talk
me.
To you. Have a great talk this afternoon.
Thanks, yeah.